Hi, I'm George Pearson, and this time around, we'll be doing this Photoshop pixel art portrait. Now, if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button and, of course, share. You can support my channel through Patreon. Don't forget to subscribe. I do several videos each week. There's my current schedule. And take a look at my complete training course for Photoshop. You'll find a link for that right down there in the description. Okay, let's get to it. This Photoshop pixel art portrait is actually very easy to do, but it does require a little trick to get this right. Let me show you how to do this. I'll just close this one down. And here's our beginning picture. Now I have a link for this. You can download this from my website. There's a link for that in the description. The first thing we need to do here is to save this file. Just do a save as. Go up here, file, save as. You want to save it with an extension pixels. I already have one up there, but there you go. Just add on pixels right there onto the name or anything else as long as you have, you know, two separate names for your file. I just like pixels at the end. Choose save. There you go. Okay, so it's been saved now as a new name right there. Let me bring up the old file again, the first file. And that's that one right there. So there's the original, and here, right here, is our saved version. We're now going to change the size of this new file. Go up to image, come down to image size right there. Notice that my original is at 1920 by 1280. This is important when we do the size change. If you're using a picture with a different size, you'll need to adjust the settings. You'll know what I mean here in just a second. Let me just change the resolution here down to 72. Change the measurement type here to percent, and then change this to 3%. That's what you might need to change depending upon the size of your original image. So here we go. Now down here where it says resample, come down to bicubic sharper reduction right there. Make sure it says that, and then choose OK. And you get a real small picture. If I just pull this window out here and we zoom in a little bit, you see we now have all that nice pixelization in there. And the 3% is what gave us the squares at about this size. So if my image was larger, I need to change my percentage wise to get just the right image. So you may need to adjust that percent. Just take a look at it, pull it up here. If it looks about like this, then you're just about where you should be. Okay, so we have that done. We've done the first half of this. That's getting our pixelization in here. We now need to enlarge this back up again to full size without losing this pixelization. And we'll do that back up here again at image, come down to image size once again, set the resolution back up to 300, set our pixels back to 1920. Don't worry about the bottom one, we'll fix that. And then where it says resample, change this to nearest neighbor hard edges. And that keeps the pixelization. You should see the squares over here left-hand side. If you don't, double check your resample over here. Okay, that's all done. Choose OK. And go back up here to the zoom. Click on fit screen. And there you go. You should see the nice large size with that nice pixelization in there. Okay, now take this image here. This is the background layer. Drag it onto our original image like that. Let's just minimize that out of the way. Now, as we saw, this wasn't exactly the same size. It was kind of just off by a bit. And you can see right down there, just a little bit short on the bottom. Left and right, it's about right. A little short on the bottom. So we'll fix that by doing a Control T keyboard shortcut. Brings up our bounding box and the control handles. Make sure that the sides are the right size. Your top is against the top. And then just pull the bottom down until it fits on the bottom. So it now fits exactly, and it's back in the right size again. And click on the check mark right there. So that's the hard part is done, is getting this pixelization at full size. Now all we need to do is go here to the layer one, go up here to where it says normal on our blend modes, and change your blend mode to overlay, and there you go. There is that pixel art portrait done, as you can see, actually very quickly. But there is a little trick to it to get that pixelization effect on that original layer up there. Let me just bring this back up again to normal. There you go, getting that pixelization effect. That's the hard part of the whole thing. And then just doing the overlay gives you that nice pixelized portrait effect. So there you go. That's how to do a Photoshop pixel art portrait.